except towards Allah. So this lecture, I want to recoup so that I can link all the lectures together so that we can identify. Now we can start identifying ourselves, who we really are. We are Muslims. Muslim is a word that comes from the one who submits. So we are submitting in the millah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of the millah of Ibrahim, which is the path of Ibrahim, or the path of all the prophets that came, that were sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of them, with all the laws and the functions that they've given us to perform, these are the things that will accelerate, that will make us identify ourselves with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your salah, your zakah, your hajj, your jihad, all of them are linked with the journey towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. None of them are separate from our journey towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As long as we identify these laws and regulations that are given to us as separate things of journeying towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we are lost. We will find ourselves as people who are obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that we get something out of Him. As Imam Ali says, there are three types of worshippers. There are those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that they can get something from Allah, which is Jannah. That is the worship of a dealer, or a businessman, or a merchant. And then there are those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they are afraid of Allah. They are afraid of the punishment that will befall them. And then it is said that is the worship of a slave. And then there is a worship that identifies with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because we are a traveling people. We are not here to stay. And then that is a worshiper that knows the position of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then that is the worshiper that knows who He really is. Because it is said, you cannot know Allah until you know yourself. So by identifying who Allah is, by knowing who Allah is, you have established a conclusion that who you are. This world is here to deceive us. As long as we identify ourselves by our tribe, more than we identify ourselves with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we are lost. You'll find people fighting one another. You'll find mischief in this world. Why? Because we identify ourselves with this world. And then with what we have acquired from this world. I identify myself as a wealthy man. I identify myself as a poor man. I identify myself as a Zulu man, a Sotho man. By identifying yourself with that only, then you have lost in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all of these are linked. Our purpose on this earth is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Ali was asked that, do you know whom you worship? Have you seen that which you have worshipped? I will never worship that thing that I don't know and that I have not seen. Meaning that as long as we have not established who we are, and as long as we have not established who Allah is, then what are we worshipping? Because sometimes we worship the idea of Allah. We don't worship Allah. We worship what we are told who Allah is. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He is closer to you than your own jugular vein. He is closer to you than your own self. So Allah is here, is with you. So our purpose on earth will never be established. We'll never accomplish our own purpose on earth as long as we have not identified who Allah is. And if we have not yet identified who Allah is, we will never identify who Allah is as long as we have not identified who we are. So it starts with you, the journey that is within. Rahimallahu man arafa min aina wa aina wa ila aina. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon the person who knows where he come from, where he is, and where he is heading. Because once you establish who, where you are going, where you are heading, then the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be upon you. The blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be upon you. This is the journey. We are not here to stay. We are not here to be stagnant. We need to grow. And towards something. Because growth is movement. You need to move towards something. There is positive growth and negative growth. If you grow for the things of this world, you grow in order to acquire the things of this world. I want to have a certain stage. I want to acquire this so that I can be at this level. I want to acquire that so that I can, as long as it doesn't have, is not moved by the purpose why you are created, then that growth is negative. But a growth that is moved by the reason why you were created, by the purpose why you are here, then that growth is positive. You'll find people say, I'm a singer, this is my purpose. You'll find people say, I'm a footballer, this is my purpose. Then once we chop off your leg, what happens to your purpose? You're no longer a purposeful person. Because why? You have attributed your purpose with things of this world. I'm a this. This is my purpose. We hear radio. I'm a doctor. This is my purpose. Doctors, how many doctors, their license have been taken away? What happens to you, to your purpose? What happens to your purpose? Our purpose is what? Ubudiya. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing else. And we have given rules and regulations that will make us identify our purpose, which is our salah, which is our all the laws of Islam. These are the things that will make us to identify our purpose. Ubudiya, worship. So without worship, if a person does not worship, he will worship something, as Quran says. He will worship something. It's either you will worship yourself, which is the biggest shirk, to worship yourself. It's either you will worship other people. It's either you will worship this world. It's either you will worship wealth. You will worship something. A man attribute, one of the attributes of man is to worship. Is to be in service of something, But once you identify what you need to worship, then you are connected with your purpose. Once you worship this world, then you will be disconnected from your purpose. Then you will be fulfilling other people's purpose or other things' purpose. It's either you fulfill the purpose of Shaitan. It's either you fulfill the purpose of this world. It's either you fulfill the purpose of your selfish purpose, ambitions, which are imprisoning you, are making you a slave. So as a human being, our purpose is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Bible says that we are created in His image. This image that we are talking about is not the physical image, but the spiritual attributes that we have. Allah is merciful, we are merciful. Allah is forgiving, we are forgiving. If you live according to the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will be like Allah. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Hadith al-Qudsi says that become the eyes that which I see, become the ears in which that I hear, become the mouth in which that I speak. You become the speech of Allah. Meaning you become the vessel that contains Allah. You become the vessels that contains Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Hadith al-Qudsi again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, all this world and the universe and everything is not enough for me, except the heart of the believer. The heart of the believer is enough to contain Allah. What kind of a vessel is this that can contain Allah?
Barakatuh. Once again, we are here commemorating the fallen heroes of Islam and commemorating the tragedies that has occurred upon the ahulubayt. This is the month in which we take advantage to introspect the events of Karbala, the events of Ashura, and then we derive lesson from so that they become applicable to our lives. Now we are blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have given us life, to have been witnessing all these days, to have been learning from all these days, to have been taking advantage of all these days and receiving the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For every gathering that is in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or a gathering that is in the name of Ahlul Bayt, or remembering of Ahlul Bayt, that gathering is blessed. And that gathering, it is said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the angels to descend in that gathering and shower the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on them. Now, inshallah, these are the days in which we should introspect ourselves. We should introspect our environment. We should introspect our neighbors, introspect our friends and families, to look after them, to introspect actually on how we should develop going forward as a community, as a, and also as individuals. Now, inshallah, my parting on this lecture, inshallah, I will be talking about sincerity. What is sincerity? Sincerity, according to mainstream dictionaries, it says like it's a absence of deceit, absence of hypocrisy, and also absence of pretense, meaning that any action that has a lot of pretense behind, or that is deceitful and that is full of hypocrisy, it is an action that lacks sincerity. Now, sincerity, it is one of the most fundamental quality of a deed. So each and every deed will be valued based on sincerity. What kind of sincerity it has, or how much sincerity it upholds. So therefore, your actions, once you put them in front of someone or in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment, they will be judged according to your sincerity. So the value of sincerity determines the value of your action. Inshallah, so most of the things that we want to do and then we don't see fruits of them is because they lack sincerity. So Imam Ali says, Al-Ikhlasu Milakul Ibadah. Sincerity is a criteria for Ibadah. So once you put yourself in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or once you present your actions in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or whenever you think of doing an action, a good deed, so it has to have sincerity. It has to be backed by sincerity. So it is the foundation of your action. So your actions cannot be accepted in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if they don't have sincerity. So these are the reasons why when we do actions, we don't see the fruits of those actions. These are the reasons why if our actions lack sincerity, they are not accepted in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, this topic, it is one of the most fundamental topics, especially during this time of Muharram. Because we can see the movement of Imam al-Hussein. It is a movement that has been coupled with pure sincerity. Hence, we see the fruits of them today. Hence, we are enjoying the fruits of Muharram today. Hence, we are commemorating these fallen heroes of today. Because these individuals who laid their lives in Karbala are individuals who had sincerity. Hence, their actions until today are celebrated because they had sincerity. So we would see in the history of Islam, many people who laid their lives for Islam, but they lacked sincerity. And you'd find that the Prophet would say that this individual will never be admitted in Jannah because of this action. Due to, because he lacked sincerity. Because we have some personal ambitions, and we also have materialistic ambitions. And we would see in the history of Islam that during battles, people would run away. During battles, people would go for beauties due to, because of, that was their prime ambition for them to start entering the issue or start being in combat with other enemies. So this implies that in order for our actions to be accepted, because that is our sole purpose, why we live in this world. So we are created so that we obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we do ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if the criteria, if your ibadah lacks the criteria of sincerity, that means that ibadah will not be accepted, meaning you'll be doomed in the day of judgment, meaning all your work in this world will be doomed. And then actually, with sincerity, with insincere actions, you'll see the repercussion of fruitless actions. You'd see that communities will crumble because someone probably started a great initiative, but he lacked sincerity. Probably he was all about himself. Probably he was chasing materialistic wealth, materialistic ambitions. Hence, we see communities crumble. Hence, we see even ourselves, individuals, we crumble. We don't succeed in every daily activities of our lives because we lack sincerity. Divorces happen because marriages started with lack of sincerity. Families become broken because these families started on without sincerity. So churches were built or mosques were built and they crumble or they become vacant. There's no one attending them because they lacked sincerity. So with sincerity, there is blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then inshallah, this will be my introduction, and we'll be exploring the issue of sincerity going forward inshallah. And then we will be coupling it with the ideology and the movement, what moved Imam Hussein, so that with this sincerity, and then will be applicable to our lives, and then we can move forward and become better human beings and develop and have actually an ambition that is derived or that is driven by Islam, or that is driven by spirituality, or that is driven by getting nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we fulfill our prime reason why we were created in the first place, which is ibadah, inshallah. And then we'll be exploring, among the sincerity, we'll be exploring the issue of how do we attain sincerity. And also we'll be discussing the benefits and the fruits of sincerity, inshallah, in the coming days, inshallah. I hope you become blessed, and then we take advantage of these days, the days of Muharram, the days in which Imam al-Hussein laid his life, for us to reflect and become better human beings, and to continue carrying the flag bearers of Imam al-Hussein, inshallah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahi ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين ثم الصلاة والسلام على الأشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين Habibi ilahi al-alamin abul qasim mustafa muhammad wa ahlal baytihi tayyibina tahirina sayyama baqiyatullahi fil ardina ma ba'd assalamu alayka assalamu ala al-husayn wa ala ali bin al-husayn wa ala awlad al-husayn wa ala ashab al-husayn wa kulli ansar al-husayn jami'an wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh وَلَعَنَتُ اللَّهِ مَنْ أَعْضَائِهِمْ إِلَى يَوْمِ هَذَا إِلَى يَوْمِ الدِّينِ أما بعد فقال تعالى في محكم الكتاب بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فإذا ركبوا في الفلك دعوا الله مخلصين له الدين فلما نجاهم إلى البر وإذا هم يشركون صدق الله العلي العظيم. Now, first and foremost, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Once again, we are commemorating the days of Muharram, the days in which one of the greatest leader, the chief of Mataya, Imam al-Hussein, laid his life. And we also remember the tragedies that occurred in the day of Ashura. Now, inshallah, as we said in the previous day, that we'll be speaking about sincerity. And then we have stipulated that the importance of sincerity, and we said that in order for your actions to be accepted, it has to be coupled with sincerity. So therefore, your actions will be valued on how sincere you were in order for them to be accepted. Now, inshallah, today I will speak about obtaining sincerity, since sincerity is something that is very paramount and very important for our lives, for our actions to be accepted, for us to fulfill our prime duty or our prime purpose on this earth, since our prime purpose being ibadah. Now, in order for our ibadah to be accepted, we need to have pure sincerity. We need to be sincere in our actions. Now, inshallah, today we'll be speaking about obtaining sincerity. Now, sincerity is not something that you can get from outside. You can get it from someone, or you can read about and get it. Sincerity is something that is within you, that needs to be activated. And once it becomes activated, you need to maintain it. Now, the first method in order for you to achieve or obtain sincerity is to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In order for you to live, to breathe, it is because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the power that you need to activate that sincerity within you and to maintain it, you need first to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we cannot live without Him. It is the reason why we are alive today. We wouldn't be performing the actions that we are performing today, the salah that you are performing today, the shukr that you are doing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sadaqah that you are performing, the zakah that you are giving out, the hajj that you are doing. It is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you life so that you can reach Him, so that He gives you one more time to reach Him, to gain nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, towards Him. So therefore, in order for us to reach Him, we need to ask from Him. One is life. Now today, since we are speaking about sincerity, the first thing that we need to do in order for you to start doing any action, you need to introspect. And then before you do any action, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you the power to activate the sincerity within you. And then also to maintain that sincerity going forward. There is one dua that we recite in the morning that says, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-yaqeen fi kalbi. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you certainty in your heart. وَالْإِخْلَاصِ فِي عَمَلِي, and the sincerity in my actions. So it is very important that the first step before you do any action, before you do anything, is that you should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first to activate the sincerity within you so that you can do the action with pure sincerity and more, so that you can sustain that sincerity. Sustaining sincerity is very difficult. You might find that you have pure sense, you are sincere in your action in the beginning, but because of temptations that comes in your way, and then that sincerity becomes derailed, or that intentions become derailed. We know of a story of Shaitan from the Bible, that he tempted even Nabi Isa alayhi wasalam. So Shaitan will come in different forms. He will come in a form of whispering. He will come in a form of a physical obstruction. He might come in a form of a human being. And then that will derail you. And then that will make your actions not to be accepted. But yet, in the beginning, it was all pure. You started purely for the reason of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the reason to get nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the reason so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can accept your actions. It is one said that every action that starts with Bismillah, it is accepted. So Bismillah is one of the things that activate or that purifies your intentions, and you become sincere in whatever you do. So therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is the first step for you to start becoming sincere in your actions. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-ikhlasul fi amali. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you sincerity in your actions. So therefore, in order for your actions to be accepted, in order for you to gain pure sincerity, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do any actions in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore you will attain, or your actions will be accepted, and then you will attain your soul purpose of why you were created in the first place. So therefore, I implore you, advise myself and you, that whenever you want to do an action, sit down, think about that action, involve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that action, so that it become accepted. Let's not allow our nafs, our shahawat, ourselves, and our feelings to take over our actions. Let's not allow our base desires to take over our actions. Let's not allow other people to take control of our actions. Let's not allow money, wealth of this world to take over our ibadat or our actions to be accepted in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is highly important that you should involve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your actions, so that your actions can be accepted. Because we are doing them so that we reach Him. Whenever you start to make salah, it is said that you must make an intention. That intention, what do you say? Qurbatan ilallah. So that we gain nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, it is our prime reason, our sole purpose, why we do these actions, is to obey Allah, so that we become closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I hope and I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us in everything that we do that pertain to getting nearer to Him. Anything that we do, we should do it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever we want to do anything, we should involve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever we want to do anything, we should begin with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.